Hello dear students, a very warm good morning to all of you and welcome in our science session. So we are discussing our lesson, that is sorting materials into group. So in this lesson already we have discussed some points, and today we will start with the new point, that is we'll see the properties of material. So in this point we are going to see the different properties of material. So in the kitchen our mother is preparing everyday food, and to make that food she is using the different utensils. But you have observed ever which type of the utensils she is using? So mostly in the kitchens we are using the utensils to cook the food, the utensils which are made up of aluminium, which are made up of steel, copper, like that metals made utensils we are using to make a food. But you have think that why we are not using the utensils which are made up of paper? Because as we know, if you will keep the paper utensils on the gas stove, then what will happen? It will catch the fire and it is unable to us to cook the food. Okay, so in this way, by this discussion, what we can say, that we can use the different types of the objects which are made up of different materials, but that materials we can choose according to the properties of that material and according to the use of certain type of the object. Okay, so here while cooking the food we are using the objects which are made up of what? Different metals, and metals cannot get melt very easily. So in this way, according to the properties of material and according to the uses of an objects, we are choose the different types of materials. So these all the materials are having the different properties, and all these properties we are going to see. So let's start with the first property of material, that is what? Appearance. Okay, now appearance means what? How does it looks? How it exactly looks? So you have seen so many types of the objects. So each and every object is different from each other. See here, now I am having this marker. So this marker is different than this wooden slides. Okay, so this wooden slides is different from this plastic, and this plastic is different from this stone. Okay, so in this way what we can say, that each and every object is different from each other because it is made up of different types of materials. So here we can say that this stone is different from this plastic, while this plastic is different from this aluminium rod. This aluminium rod is different from this copper rod, and this copper rod is different from this iron rod. Okay, means to look, all these things looks different, but in the aluminium rod, in the copper rod, and in the iron rod, the one property is same. Still these objects are different, because these all the objects which are made from the different material, that material contains the same property or same characteristics. Okay, so let's discuss all these appearance with the help of one activity. So what is the aim of our activity? To separate the shiny materials from the given object. So see here, I am having certain things over here. I am having this sandpaper, this is the wooden block, this is iron block, I am having this aluminium rod, this is iron rod, and this is copper rod, and this is the plastic bottle. So what is our thing is that we have to rub all these different objects with the help of this sandpaper. Okay, with the help of this sandpaper, now I will rub the surface of each object. So first I will rub this wooden block with this sandpaper, and you have to observe it whether there is any change happens in the object or no. So see, this is what? Wooden block. Okay, so I will rub this wooden block. Can you see any change in it? Okay, though there is no any change in the surface of the wooden block. Next one, I will take this plastic bottle, again I will rub it. Can you see any change in it? No, the surface of the plastic bottle doesn't change. Now I will take this copper rod. Okay, I will rub the surface of this copper rod. Now see here, can you see certain change in it? Can you see the shining surface on the aluminium rod? Yes, we can see the shining surface on the aluminium rod. Next one, we will take this copper rod. Okay, now I will rub this copper rod with the help of this sand paper. Okay, now see here, can you see any change? Yes, we can see the somehow shiny surface on this copper rod. Next one, now I am having this iron rod. Okay, now I will rub this iron rod also. Now see here, can you see the change on it? Yes, we can see the change on it. We can see the shining surface on these. Okay, so from this activity what we can say that there are the certain materials by rubbing that we can see the certain types of the shine on that, and that shine is called as what? Luster. Okay, so the special kind of shine present on materials is called luster. What is mean by luster? So here we can see on the aluminium rod, on the copper rod, and on the iron rod, after rubbing that surface of these all rods, we can see the shiny surface on it, and that shine is called as what? Luster. Okay, a special kind of shine present on materials, and that shine is called as what? Luster. So this shine we can see by rubbing that surface of a material, or whenever we are cutting the material freshly, that time also we can see the luster on it. So there are the so many types of the materials. We can say that mostly the metals, all the metals are having the shine. We can say that iron, copper, aluminium, all these materials are having lusters, and that is the reason they are called as what? Lusterous material. Okay, they are called as what? Lusterous material. While we can say that these are the wooden block and this is the plastic bottle, we have rubbed all these two things with the help of the sandpaper, but they have not shown any type of the shine on it. It means what? They doesn't have any shine, that doesn't show this lustrous property. Okay, so mostly the metals are having this lustrous property, and that is the reason we can say that the gold and the silvers are used in the making of the jewelry. Okay, and they are having the high cost also because of this very important property, that is what? Lustrous property. This luster is also called as what? Chamak. Okay, it gets lustrous when it comes under the light. Next one, we can say that there are the certain types of the objects, or there are the certain types of the materials which lose their lustrous property when they comes in the contact of air, water, or moisture. We can say that this copper rod, or you have seen so many types of the copper utensils at your home. If you keep it as it is in the air or outside, then after a certain period of the time, it gets dull in the color. Their shining properties go away. Why? Because the key comes in the contact of air, water, and moisture. They react with that all the things and they lose their shining properties. Okay, so this is the first property of material we have seen, that is what? Appearance. Means the different objects are there, but they are having their appearance are different, but sometimes they are having the same properties. So what we can say that? So this iron, copper, aluminium, silver, gold, all these are the metals which looks different. Their appearance are different, but they are having one same property, that is what? They are having this lustrous property. They are having some shine over it, some chamak on it, and that property is called as what? Lustrous property. Or we can say that materials are called as what? Lustrous materials. Okay, so this is all about appearance. So now let's discuss the next property of material, that is texture. Okay, now texture means what? How it feels. Okay, so whenever we touch to the different objects, we can feel different. Okay, so all the objects doesn't have the same texture. Some objects are rough while the some objects are smooth. Okay, some objects or the we are discussing here materials. So we can say here what? Some materials are rough while the some materials are smooth. But how we can come to know which material is so smooth and rough? Because of the touching them. And how we can come to know that it is rough or smooth? How it is rough and smooth? Why it is rough and smooth? Because these rough materials are having the bumps or the ridges on it that we can felt. Okay, so whenever we are touching on the rough surface, then we can feel these bumps or the ridges, and that is the reason we can say to that material what? This material is rough. Generally we can say that what? The wooden is having the rough surface. Also we can say the rocks are having the rough surface because they are having the bumps or the ridges. Bumps means what? The upper, or they are having the ups and downs on the surface. That's why it can feel the rough. Also we can say the bark of tree is also having rough surface because they are having the bumps and ridges on it. So the very important thing is that texture is also different about the different material. There are the rough materials. Why they are rough? Because they are having the bumps and ridges on the surface. Opposite to the rough material, there is smooth material. Now smooth material doesn't have any bumps or the ridges on it. It has the plain surface, and that is the reason we can feel it smooth. Okay, so this is about smooth surface. We can say that the plain or the petals, they are very smooth because they don't have any types of the bumps or the ridges on it. So this is the next property of material, that is what? Texture. That we can say that some materials are rough, some are smooth. Okay, rough, why they are rough? Because they are having bumps or ridges on it, and the smooth materials doesn't have bumps or ridges on it. Now the next one property of the material we will discuss, that is hardness. So if you have seen the so many things around us, or so many things around yourself, so many objects around yourself, we can say that see here I am having this sponge. So if I'll compress it, it change its shape. Okay, I can easily compress this sponge. But see here I am having this iron block. I can compress this. See, I am applying the same pressure, but it is unable to compress this. It is unable to compress this iron block. Why? Because there are the certain materials, that materials are what? Hard, and there are the certain materials that are soft. So what is meant by the soft materials? The materials that can be easily compressed. Okay, the material that can be compressed are called soft material. Compress means what? We can change their shape here. Okay, like this, we can compress it, we can make it short. Okay, so materials that can be compressed are called soft material. For example, we can see this sponge, also we can say that foam. All these are the example of soft material. Opposite to that, there is another property of material, that is what? Hard material. So there are the certain materials that cannot be compressed, and they are called as hard materials. So materials that cannot be compressed are called hard material. So see here, iron block is there. I am compressing it, I am trying to apply it pressure, trying to compress it, but it is unable to compress it. Why? Because it is a hard material. See here, I am having this copper rod. I am trying to compress it, but it is unable to compress this copper rod because it has the hard material. Okay, it is made up of hard material. So basically all the metals are having hard property, or they are having the all the metals are made up of hard material. And because of these properties of the metals are used in the utensils, and they are also used in the different factories. Okay, so this is all about today. Today we have discussed about the properties of material. We have discussed about first property, that is appearance. Also we have discussed about the texture, and also we have discussed about the hardness. So this is all about today. Also we have discussed about the hardness, but here I want to add one key sentence. Okay, so there is a one substance which is a natural hardest substance, that is nothing but what? Diamond. So the diamond is the natural substance which is so much hard, it is the hardest substance. Okay, and that is the reason the diamond is used to cut the glass or to grinding the glass. So this is all about today. Here we will stop. We will meet in the next video with the next point. This is the time to tell you goodbye, and for today, thank you.